Hi guys, so this is going to be a tutorial on my summer face routine, which is what I'm wearing right now on my face. And I'm actually not wearing foundation really, I just mixed my face moisturizer, which is my Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel, with one of my favorite foundations, my Revlon Colorstay foundation, and this one is in 370 Toast in the normal to dry skin formulation. Throughout this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to make your own tinted moisturizer so that you don't have to go out and spend money and try to find your shade and buy tinted moisturizer and blah blah yada yada. You can easily make your own tinted moisturizer using your favorite foundation. It'll already be in your shade, so it'll be perfect. And then your favorite face moisturizer, and you probably have both of these readily available in your makeup kit or collection. And this is basically my summer face routine. I don't wear makeup every single day, so there's days when I just put on moisturizer and sunscreen and then I'm out the door. So this is my face routine when I want a really nice natural yet kind of flawless coverage. Tinted moisturizer is a great way to get the best of both worlds. It's moisturizing and hydrating, and then it is going to give you some coverage. All I did was apply my moisturizer first, then face primer, then my tinted moisturizer concoction, then concealer under the eyes, and set my face using my MAC Mineralize Skin Finish Natural. Then I just applied some bronzer to give a really nice glow and luminous cheek. So this look is very simple and it's perfect for the summertime because it's very, very hot, humid, and if you're wearing liquid foundation or something that's very heavy on your face, it can start to run and melt and be an icky mess. And we definitely want to look fabulous, fresh, and flawless even in the summertime, so I think that tinted moisturizer and powder or mineral foundation is going to be perfect for the summer months when you still want to get that really nice flawless look but you don't want anything too heavy on your face. As always, there will be a detailed product list down below of all of the products that I use throughout this tutorial. So if you want to see my summer face routine, and also if you want to see how you can save some money and make your own tinted moisturizer, then definitely stay tuned for the tutorial. Bye guys. So first, what I'm going to do is take a bit of my face moisturizer, and this is the Clinique Dramatically Different Moisturizing Gel. I'm going to go ahead and apply it to my clean face. Next, I'm going to use a face primer. I'm going to use the BH Cosmetics Foundation Primer, and I'm going to take a pump of that on my fingers and then work that all over my face as well, concentrating it here in my T-zone, which is where I get oily because I don't have oily skin, but I do get a bit of oil here in my T-zone. So I'm just concentrating it here. Then I'm going to work the rest all over my face. Now I'm going to take my foundation. The foundation that I'm going to be using is my Revlon Colorstay foundation, and this one is in shade 370 Toast, and I have this in the normal to dry formulation. Depending on the coverage you want for your tinted moisturizer, the amount of foundation and moisturizer that you add will vary. I personally want a very light, natural coverage, so I'm going to use two parts moisturizer and one part foundation. But if you want more coverage, you can always do an even amount. You can do one part moisturizer and then one part foundation, or you can do two parts foundation and one part moisturizer. On the tips of my fingers, I'm just going to do two pumps of my face moisturizer. My Revlon Colorstay unfortunately doesn't have a pump, so I'm just going to eyeball it and do one part of foundation. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to work this in my fingers, just mixing this together, and I'm going to start applying this to my face using my clean finger. I'm just going ahead and just patting it on at first. Then I'm going to start to work it in a circular motion. And I'm going to do it around my brows because I've already filled in my brows, so I don't want to mess those up, so I'm just going to do it very carefully around my brows. Then what I like to do is take a liquid concealer that's a few shades lighter than my skin tone and apply that underneath my eyes to give that Kim K inspired bright under eye look. Then I'm going to set my under eye concealer using a translucent powder, and this is MAC's Translucent Set Powder. And this is just going to lock in the concealer, but it's also going to continue to give me that brightening effect underneath my eyes, which I wouldn't get if I went ahead and set my entire face and under eye concealer with my regular face powder. Next, I'm going to apply my face powder. The powder that I use for my face is the MAC Mineralize Skin Finish Natural. I'm going to apply that using my Sigma Buffer Brush. And first, I just like to pat the powder on, then I start to blend it in a circular motion. I make sure to blend a line here where the concealer and the rest of my foundation meet, just so that it's not so noticeable and drastic. During the summer months, I like to add a bit of a glow to my face and to my cheeks by applying bronzer. I'm going to be applying this bronzer, which is from Wet n Wild, and this one is in Princess. To highlight my face, I'm going to be using another bronzer. This bronzer is from e.l.f. and this is one of their Healthy Glow Bronzing Powders, and this one is in Sunkiss. And it's a really nice golden color, so it looks really great with my skin tone. I'm just going to pop this right here above my cheekbones.